In the winter of 1948, the Soil Conservation Council took over Adair Farm, a derelict holding of 135 acres, with the aim of determining the effect of conservation farming methods in restoring such depleted hillsides to profit. In spring, they started ploughing. The water-filled level was a good idea, but turned out to be a bit too primitive. The object is to lay out the terraces to have a measured and very slight fall towards a waterway at the end of the paddock. Though the apparatus is now obsolete, the method of marking out the line of the first furrow still applies. The farm is in South Canterbury, a few miles out of Timaru. The vertical intervals between terraces were set out using standard surveyor's apparatus. The tractor moved in to make the first furrow of the first terrace on the slip. There had been no previous experience of building broad-based terraces in New Zealand, so a number of soil conservation officers did the work themselves in order to learn as much as possible. Vertical intervals of 6 feet were used at Adair. That is to say, each terrace is 6 feet higher above sea level than the one below it. It takes several runs of the disc terracer to start the terrace, usually about 5 runs each way. Later, a run with a greater blade is needed to smooth off the bank and the wide depression above it. Towards the end of building a terrace, the level is checked. At this stage, higher tractor speeds are possible, as small furrows only have to be thrown to the top of the mound. The tilt of the bank in towards the hill is checked. There must be no tendency for rainwater to run over the lip. Adair Farm was converted by the original settlers from virgin soil into a profitable small holding, but it later deteriorated through years of unsuccessful management, some paddocks becoming gorse infested and some severely sheet eroded. Now it takes on a new appearance. After 2 seasons, the whole of the old farm was taking the new shape. The main grazing area is a long hillside set out in graded banks. A modification of the terraces, graded banks are useful on steeper country. They have a slight fall towards a grassed waterway on the left, so that excess water is led down to the creek during exceptionally heavy rainfalls. When grazing the paddocks, sheep usually start feeding on the top of the structures, where the grass seems especially palatable. Under normal rains, there is no runoff at all from the terraced hillside. To measure the runoff from part of the same hillside which has not been terraced, special apparatus was installed, including a settling tank to measure the amount of topsoil washed down at each rainstorm. Permanent records are kept of temperatures and of wind force and direction, and regular information is contributed to the weather office. To complete the meteorological equipment, a recording barometer is also kept in operation at the farm. Winter work has included tree planting and all the usual farm maintenance jobs. Here in South Canterbury, maintenance includes keeping gorse hedges within limits and relocating fences. On the cultivated slopes, autumn-sown lupin was the crop used on the rotation in 1950. Here, ploughing and drilling is done on the contour. But for experimental comparison with the contour-sown slopes, part of the area has been cultivated up and downhill for each crop. After all measurements for comparison had been made, sheep were let into graze. The main purpose of lupin in the rotation is to build up the soil, but it also provides feed. Land which in 1948 produced weed-infested crops was already by 1950 producing good crops. Spring 1950, and the slopes which were in lupin are being prepared for barley. Smoothed out waterways in the hollows are kept permanently in grass. There is really no level land amongst these rolling hills. On gently sloping pasture areas, contour furrows are ploughed to conserve moisture and prevent surface runoff. Like the broad-based terraces and graded banks, the furrows are given a very slight fall towards the end of the paddock, so that if rainfall should exceed rate of absorption, the surplus water would flow slowly along controlled channels. All the life of this hilly farm is on the move towards summer. A gorse patch where the ground is so badly eroded that there is not enough topsoil for pasture is being reclaimed by planting trees. Some of the cultivated slopes were autumn sown in barley, which made a fine strike. Summer is here, the third summer since the farm was taken over. Buildings as well as land are being brought up to standard, and the harvest is in progress. It is on cultivated land that terracing proves to have made the greatest difference. Although crop rotation and treatment were identical over these slopes for a four-year period, the terraced parts yielded 60 bushels to the acre, against only 12 bushels per acre cultivated up and downhill. Though this land is terraced, the header harvester moves freely across it in every direction. On this hillside, rainfall, topsoil and fertility elements are retained just as well as they would be on level land. Under the rotation of crops practiced, the soil is steadily improving. Terraces and contour cultivation are the major factors in raising the yield of this paddock to 60 bushels, instead of the 12 bushels obtained from entirely comparable sloping paddocks cultivated up and downhill. Summer 1954-55. At Adair, normal farm work and research into the results of terracing go on side by side. To measure and compare grass production on terraced and unterraced slopes, standard wire cages are set out in the paddocks to keep test areas ungrazed. A swath of grass round the outside of the impression made by the cage is cut and discarded. As slopes under pasture is not as vulnerable to erosion as cultivated slopes, Terracing cannot be expected to cause as spectacular an increase for grass as it did for barley. The rectangle remaining, the grass which grew within the cage, is now cut and bagged to be weighed and analysed. The tests are showing that the terraced pastures of the farm have over 3 years grown 30% more grass than the unterraced slopes. To measure the exact production, the total weight of grass from each plot is recorded in the laboratory, and a sample weighed and dried to give total dry matter. Terracing gives 30% increase of feed. The line showing production from terraced pastures stays well above the line for production on the uncontoured slopes right round the seasons. The runoff plots this summer are being used to check the erosion consequences of different types of soil treatment. Another approach to runoff characteristics of soils uses portable water spraying equipment. The operator visited Adair with his truck during the course of a survey of the whole country. The first requirement for this line of work is a standard head of water, which is maintained by a small pump. Inside canvas screens, sprays are concentrated on a contained area of soil surface. Owing to changes as the soil becomes moistened, rate of runoff has to be measured for several minutes, sometimes for as long as an hour until it becomes constant. Differing managements of the soil can have great influence on how much rainfall sinks in. Patches of ground too steep for any kind of contour work have been fenced off and planted in trees for future timber and shelter. When there is a little time to spare, these small cedars benefit from having grass cleared from round their roots. In time, there will be a variety of timbers available. Over in the gorse area, the Douglas firs are well established, and will soon be overshadowing the gorse and in no further need of attention. Even now, all they really need is to have their leaders singled, so that they will later make useful timber. Contour work has been proved successful. By reducing runoff, it has conserved and built up topsoil. By conserving moisture, it has given 30% increase in production. As the results become more widely understood, the orderly pattern of contours will spread more and more over the rolling downland farms of South Canterbury. Most of the Adair acreage had been improved by 1955, but there were still patches of rough grazing. Every good farming practice was followed on the slope below, except that seed was drilled up and down hill, and one coulter set no seed. Had drilling been done along the contour, a blocked coulter could not have caused loss of soil. Late afternoon on the graded banks. The scene on this recently derelict land speaks for itself. Contour farming is giving permanent high production of healthy stock on healthy land. Reflections of Adair Farm are now to be seen on several other farms in the catchment area. This reflection is at Taiko. At Taiko, as at Adair, steep areas are waste no longer, for they're raising timber. All ploughing has been done along the contour, and waterways maintained in grass to prevent gullying. Another Taiko grassed waterway, this one taking the runoff from tiers of fairly massive terraces. The area has been in turnips before being grassed. The whole of the farm is being run on contour conservation principles. There is a contrast in the background here. Right up to the hilltops, pasture furrows conserve the moisture and prevent concentration of runoff. From the ends of the furrows, excess water flows down grassed slopes towards a very useful stock pond. The normal level of these ponds is about two-thirds full. Another stock pond, this one fed from graded terraces, can be seen at Albury. In heavy rains, the runoff tops up the pond instead of raising the river. The water is piped to troughs for stock. Not only lambs are being fostered here, the soil too is being built up. Because it supplements river works by reducing the flood water to be carried, contour work on the hills is subsidized by the catchment board. Near Cave too, terraces prevent runoff into the Opihi River by helping the raindrops to sink in where they fall. On this farm, as at Adair, areas needing different management are fenced off from each other. As the pattern first demonstrated at Adair Farm changes the hill landscapes of South Canterbury, it will result in more moisture held in the land and less floodwaters for the river. It will mean greater safety for the farmers below on the plains, as well as about 30% permanent increased pastoral production for the farmers on the hills.